Hi, welcome to PiSignage. In today's video, we're going to go over the collaboration feature in PiSignage. Adding another account as a collaborator is a great way to help multiple people manage your account. Adding a collaborator gives them very specific access based on what you choose, either to a group, either to a certain set of playlists or a certain set of assets, so that they can add assets, add playlists, manage your groups, or even make payments on your behalf. In today's video, I've signed into my account on PiSignage, and we have three groups, which is the cat group, the collaborator group, and the default group that comes with every account. We also have a certain group of assets and a certain group of playlists that we have created already. We've also created another account called Rajat's Collaborator that we'll be adding to the Rajat account, and this is the account where we'll be toying around with the access right so that I can show you what exactly that would mean for each different access right that you give. To add a collaborator, you either need to know their username or their email ID. If they don't already have an account on PiSignage.com, you could create an account while adding them as a collaborator. To do this, we're going to go to my settings menu, and up top we're going to see collaborators. I'm simply going to click on add, and over here we have the option to add a new user, which would ask me to pick a user ID, email ID, password, etc. We could alternatively search for a username that already exists, like in this case Rajat's collaborator. As soon as you enter the name, you will see a drop down that prompts you on all the accounts available with that user. I'm simply going to click on Rajat's collaborator, which is now going to add our username to this account as a collaborator. Below, you can see the various access rights that you have access to, and we're going to go over these one by one. For now, I'm just going to click on save and not change any of the default access rights, and we can see here that Rajat's collaborator has been added as a collaborator successfully. Given the access rights that we've given Rajat's collaborator, I'm now going to switch to Rajat's collaborator account. So over here on Rajat's collaborator, we can click on welcome Rajat's collaborator to open up the profile settings. Over here, you're going to see one section which says accessible accounts. And over here we can see Rajat and the account that we are on currently, which is Rajat's collaborator. I'm just going to switch to the Rajat account. Now that I'm in the Rajat account, I can actually manage this account, like add assets, add playlists, change playlists within groups, change group settings, etc. You can see over here that I can click on assets to see all of the assets over here. I can add an asset if I choose to. I can see all of the playlists. And if I go back to groups, I can even click on a group to change the schedule or add new playlists to the schedule. Now that we have learned how to add a collaborator and what it means when you add a collaborator, I'm just going to move on to the various access rights that are there. Over here, I'm going to go back to settings and click on Rajat's collaborator, which is going to open up all of the access rights for that collaborator. In PiSignage, groups are an integral part of how access is granted to a collaborator. Over here, we can see that you can give access to all, none, or very specific groups within the account. We also have additional settings. For example, you could make the groups view only, where the user can only view which groups are there. You could also give access alternatively to group settings, the ability for a collaborator to change the default playlist, and the ability for a collaborator to change the scheduling of different playlists. For this example, I'm just going to take away the default and scheduling aspects along with group settings and make all of these groups view only. So right now, our collaborator has access to the cat group and can view the group only. So when I click on save, on switching to Rajat's collaborator, I'm just going to go to groups, where we can see that only the cat group is visible. I'm unable to schedule or change the default playlist, and there are no group settings available to me. If I were to simply go back, give access to the default playlist and the scheduling of playlists and group settings, and click on save, you can see here when I reload the page for the collaborator that the page looks very different, where I now have access to settings, scheduling of playlists, the default playlist, and even the deploy options. We can now move on to the player section of the access rights. When I click on the cat group over here, you can see that while we have a few playlists assigned, there are no players registered to this group. Hence, when we go to the collaborator account, which has access only to the cat group, when I click on the players, there are no players visible here. This is even though there are three players actually registered, all to the default group. We can come back here to the player screen of the main account. I'm going to click on the settings icon of the player, and I'm going to change the assigned group to the cat group. On doing that, you can see that Demo TV is now assigned to the cat group. I've done this as the admin of this account. Once I go back to my collaborator account, you can see here that while it said no players, once we reload the page, we should be able to view Demo TV and access the player. You can also manage very specific access rights for the collaborator, like their ability to register a player, change the player settings, and even access the PiSignage. Now I'm just going to go over these really quickly. Registering a player will allow the user to register a brand new player to the very specific group that they have access to, in this case, the cat group. Player settings, again, would give them access to all of the settings. Now, while they do have access to these settings, changing the assigned group can only be changed to either none or the cat group, which is the only group that this collaborator has access to. The player terminal would be this terminal where they can issue Linux commands and preview what exactly is playing on this player. With that, we're ready to move on to the next section, which is the content scope. The content scope is essentially the assets and the playlists which are assigned to that very specific group. I do want to call out the difference between assigning a playlist or an asset to a group versus scheduling or setting a playlist as a default playlist to the group. If we were to go to our group and click on the cat group, we can see here that the cat's playlist has been scheduled either as the default playlist or as one of the playlists over here. Now, since we have restricted the content scope, these, even though they're scheduled but not assigned to the cat group, will not be visible to the collaborator. To assign a playlist, you're going to go to playlist, click on the checkbox here that is along the cat's playlist, and click on multiple, click on assign to a group, and I'm going to check the cat group and click on proceed. Now we have the cat's playlist assigned to that one group. Similarly, I'm going to go to assets. We have one image of a cat, which I'm going to again check, and I'm going to click on multiple and click on assign to groups, cat group, and proceed. Once we go back to a collaborator account, which is Rajat's collaborator, I'm going to go to playlist where we can now see cats since it is assigned to the group cat group. Similarly, when we go to assets, we can see cat.jpg, which has again been assigned to the group cat group. Another important call out I want to make is when you limit the content scope of the collaborator, any asset uploaded by them, like I'm going to do here, where I click on add a link, I'm going to select this funny video of cats, I'm going to paste the link address and say cat video, click on save. You can see that while our cat video has been added, you can see that it's been assigned to the cat group. Another setting that we want to go over in content scope is restrict to admin and group content. This would mean that while you have access to the playlists and the assets assigned to the group, you also have access to any content that the admin uploads onto their account. Within the content scope access rights, you can see that there are specific access rights for assets and playlists themselves. The final setting that we are going to look at is the access to settings and payments, which are the bottom two right here. I'm going to check both of these and click on save. Now when we go to a Collaborator account, we can see that they didn't have access to settings and payments earlier. So on reloading the page, now that we've given them access, they should see two new tabs, which is subscriptions and licenses and settings. Subscriptions and licenses essentially allows your Collaborator to make payments on behalf of the admin and their account. Settings would give access to the Collaborator to make changes to the overall settings of the entire account. Do bear in mind that while you could give complete access to your account over to a Collaborator, the one thing a Collaborator can never do is add, edit, or manage other collaborators. Editing, adding, and managing collaborators is a privilege that only the admin of the account has access to. This means if you are a collaborator on an account and you want to add another collaborator, you will have to ask the admin to do so for you. With that, we come to the end of the video. And as always, if you have any questions, concerns, or queries, please write to support@pisignage.com. With that, thank you so much for watching and see you next time.